Good evening and welcome to Sights and Sounds of Historic Berks County. I'm your host for the evening, Amanda Machik, Vice President of the Berks Heritage Council. And tonight I am joined by John Hibschman, President of the Historic Preservation Trust of Berks County, and Autumn Shaner, Curatorial Assistant from the Boyertown Museum of Historic Vehicles. Welcome, both
of
you.
Thank you.
We are going to go ahead and get started with John from the Historic Preservation Trust. How are you tonight, John?
I'm very good.
Good to hear.
Thanks for inviting me.
Yes, of course. Would you like to start by giving us a little bit of background on the Historic Preservation Trust for those that might not know what or where it is?
The Historic Preservation Trust was formed in the mid-60s. Initially to preserve the Mounts Jones House, which was the oldest building in Berks County, located down below Douglasville along the Schuylkill River. It was built in 1716. That was the initial project, and then over the years, the trust has acquired seven additional properties, which has involved eight historic houses.
Wow.
And they are all 18th century.
And those are all scattered throughout the
county,
correct? They're
scattered throughout
the
county.
All right.
There's four down near Douglasville, one near Oley, two really, on Boyer Road between Oley and in Pike Township, and then one up on the 422 to the east of Kutztown.
Very nice. Now, I believe you had some events that you wanted to talk about, right? A couple of programs coming up at the Trust.
Yes, we do.
And then also a little bit about the National Historic Landmark that just got nominated this year. Very exciting.
Yes. Well, first, we're having third Saturday programs, and we're going to have one on June 17th, one August 19th, September 16th, October 21st, and we had one this past weekend.
That's right.
In which we showed a few people through the houses and showed them the work that we've done on the houses, especially the Mounts Jones House.
Yeah, that was archaeology, right?
And then also an archaeological dig
that we're doing
next to Mounts Jones. I mean, and we're discovering an awful lot of information and history about the site.
Excellent. Wonderful.
And then later, we're going to have an open house at the Keim Homestead on July 15th. And what we're really going to be doing is commemorating the fact that the homestead has, at the end of last year, was nominated and granted historic, National Historic Landmark status, which is really a very significant recognition for any property, and it's probably one of only about 170 buildings in Berks in Pennsylvania that have this status. It really is significant. There are two others in Pennsylvania, in Berks County, that have it, and one is Gruber Wagon Works, and the other is Conrad Weiser. So you see how very, very significant.
Yeah, very prestigious. Wow.
Yeah, it's recognized the fact that the Keim Farmstead is a major historic resource in Berks County.
So how long did that nomination take, and what exactly did it entail? I'm sure it wasn't just simple form. Here you go. I'm sure there's probably more to it than that, right?
It took more than 2 years. And the nomination, what we filed, was very complex. I think it was probably 30 or 40 pages. A total description of the historic significance of the building.
Wow.
And the architecture of the building. So it was a major project, yes.
Now, am I correct that there were letters of support as well that you needed to obtain
from... We have
people from all over the country, not even just Berks County.
That's right.
I believe you had people from Virginia and North Carolina even that wrote.
Absolutely.
Professionals, Pennsylvania German historians, and
right, we did
all sorts of.
And you know, state
Henry
representatives.
Henry Meiser, I think. Yeah, the state.
You know, David Maloney, Mark Gillum, Christian Leinbach, and then just different people involved in historic structures or organizations around Berks County.
Yep.
Sime Bartlett, Gabriel Lanier, who was professor of history, James Madison University. John Larson, who's vice president for restoration of Old Salem. So we really got a lot of national support on this.
Very good. Very exciting.
So we're very proud of it.
Yeah. Yeah. Wonderful. Wonderful.
Now what we got to do is make sure the buildings don't fall down.
Exactly. So you're having this big open house on July 15th. What will be happening? Obviously, trying to garner public support. Obviously,
right.
Going to try and raise some money.
Right.
During that event.
Yeah, and we will have different presenters of historic materials, historic things.
Guest speakers, things
guest
like
speakers,
that.
Guest speakers, yes. Yeah.
Wonderful.
And in that process, you know, we will have the Keim Homestead, which is the house itself, open. We have an historic cider press called the Hartman Cider Press at the property. That will be open, and this is a huge thing. When you talk about a cider press,
it's a building, right?
It's really
indoors.
A building. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a building.
I think I've seen it once or twice, but
yeah,
it's unique.
Oh, it is unique.
It is big.
And then the homestead has an ancillary building, which was really the workhouse for the homestead, which is a very significant woodworker and carpentry building on the property. And then we'll have other things there like face painting, quill pen writing, butter making, you know, other kinds of presentations.
Demonstrations, activities.
And demonstrations. We'll also have gun building and perhaps a militia muster.
Very nice.
So it'll really be focused on commemorating the historical significance.
And what kind of improvements are you looking to make at the property?
Well, the major issue right now is we think there are problems, or there are problems at the ancillary building.
Is that the workhouse building?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
In that there are some structural issues that have developed over the years. And this just happened. You know, this building was built 1752, I think, which means it's, 270 years. So things just deteriorate.
It's entitled to some
R&R,
right?
There's some things we have to do to fix it up.
Yeah. Very nice. Very nice. Now, does the Trust have a Facebook website?
Oh, of course we do. You know how to handle that. I don't. We do have a website, and it's historicpreservationtrust.org, and then on Facebook at Historic Preservation Trust of Berks County. And you can look at them to see the programs. But on the website, I think there is so much available. There's information about the buildings, there's drawings, there's plans for the buildings. We have an archive that shows the work we do in renovating the buildings and the research we have accomplished and the information we have. It's really, I think, very significant.
That's right. So there is a whole online archive there as well that people can access through the website.
Yes.
Very nice.
So I think what the Trust has, we have a very significant set of buildings. We have very significant archaeological work being done down around the Mounts Jones house. Mm-hmm. And then we also have this archive that shows you the history. So I think we have developed quite a combination of materials.
Many layers.
Yeah, many layers.
Wonderful.
We're not just the preservers of some old buildings at this point.
Exactly. There's definitely far more to it than that, right? Wonderful.
Yes.
Anything else you'd like to add before we move on to
Boyertown? We always need people to help.
Volunteers,
we're always looking for volunteers.
And you do have members, right? So there's
we have
a membership
members.
Organization,
yeah.
So people can join. And I believe that's on the website,
yeah,
right? Membership
on the
information.
Website. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah.
Excellent. Wonderful. Well, thank you so much. We will move on to Autumn. How are you tonight?
I'm good, Amanda. How are you?
Good, good. So I know there's a lot going on at the Boyertown Museum of Historic Vehicles.
Tons to talk about.
But if you'd like to start by giving us a little bit of just background on the museum.
Sure.
Where obviously it's in Boyertown, but a little bit more about it, and then we can talk a little bit about your renovations.
Sure. So the Boyertown Museum, it's located on 85 South Walnut Street in Boyertown, as Amanda said. What makes our museum unique is that we are all Pennsylvania-built vehicles. So everything in our museum was built right here in our backyard in Pennsylvania. Berks County, we have things Reading, Fleetwood, Boyertown, Philadelphia in the main line.
Very
so
nice.
It really stretches all over the mm-hmm. state. We even have a few out in the west that mm-hmm. were made out in the western part of Pennsylvania. We also have other modes of transportation, so bicycles, penny farthings, we have motors, and a big attraction with the museum recently has been our 1872 carriage factory, mm-hmm. which is now open to the public for blacksmithing demonstrations.
Okay.
That's been really popular.
Yeah.
So it's admission's $8 and children 15 and under are free. So that's a pretty good deal.
Yeah.
And we have some really rare pieces in the museum, and we really like to think it's a hidden gem in Berks County.
Very cool. Very cool. So the museum is undergoing some renovations that are finished.
Yes, they are finished.
Okay. finally.
Yes, finally finished.
When did they start again?
So I believe it started around the beginning of February.
Winter, yeah. Okay.
Yeah, it was over the winter. We started doing some work. Mm-hmm. February, mm-hmm. it started. Mm-hmm. And we just wrapped up about maybe 3 weeks ago or so.
Wonderful.
And actually, I have some photos if
All right.
I could show them.
Pull those up.
Let me see here. What we did was we re-poured a floor. We rebuilt walls. We have new lighting.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
We have a whole new gallery layout, which is in time order, which is really neat. So I have some pictures here.
Yeah. Could we pull up the photos?
Perhaps if they come up.
There we go.
Cool. Okay. So these are just the, let's see if I can do that. Oh, cool.
There you go.
Of the concrete being poured.
So the floor was, if I remember correctly, when you guys were on the show a few months ago, the floor was cracking and it was in really.
It was, some of it was in poor shape.
Yeah.
The building's over 50 years old, mm-hmm. so it's definitely going to happen. And it was time. It really, oh, here's the food truck fair. We're going to stop it right there. I don't want to talk about that yet. It's the renovations went really well and, they're all wrapped up. We are reopening this Saturday, May 27th, is our grand reopening. It's all day, 9:30 to 4.
Okay.
And we will have live blacksmithing. We will have refreshments. We'll have docents all throughout the museum to answer any questions that you would have. And it should be exciting. And we're really excited about the new gallery layout. It's really neat. It's really, really
so
cool.
So you did, there's the floor, the walls, and then rearrange the gallery space.
Yes,
well.
I'll show you. We can bring up just a few more photos, maybe. But.
So, by walls, do you mean walls that you almost like partitions throughout the museum? Because I'm thinking when I was there before, it's just like it had been one big open room.
So we had some partitions in the middle that we ripped down. We put some new ones up.
Oh, cool.
We
Very
built
nice.
Along our Walnut Street side. We built a whole new wall there and covered some of those older windows that were there.
Oh, yeah.
So that
okay.
kind of adds okay. to the Duryea exhibit, which is right there. Here's some photos of us moving the vehicles, which was quite interesting.
Yeah.
I'll just do it on
oh
this
my
thing.
Goodness.
It's easier. So here's some volunteers just moving the vehicles. It was really extraordinary how many volunteers came out to help us. It was unbelievable.
It was not an easy task.
And that's for food truck, which is the next thing I want to talk about,
All right.
actually.
All right, well, we can go head on to that.
Sure. So this is our third annual food truck fair, and it's called The Truck Stops Here, Mobile Madness. It's going to take place on June 17th from 12 to 4. And these are all, if you can bring this, just this one image up anyway, this is all the food trucks that are going to be at this event, which we're really proud of. So we have Captain Chucky's Seafood, which is lobster rolls. The first year we had this event, we had lobster rolls, and people want them back. And I don't blame them. They were delicious. So they're doing seafood. I mean, it sounds really good. Milk and Sugar, that's baked goods. Wow Wagon, which is local. They do burgers and things. My Mom's Polish Food Cart is out of Philadelphia. They're very popular. They do homemade pierogies, which are really good. Philly Fry, Gourmet Fries. Mr. Softy, Sly Fox, which is, of course, beer. Mm-hmm. Can't forget that. And Gourmand, which is out of YMSC, PA. But what makes this event unique is when we were the Boyertown Auto Body Works, before we became the museum, we manufactured truck bodies. So yeah, when
it
you
could
come,
not be more fitting.
It's so fitting. So when you come into this event, you're going to see food trucks that were manufactured right here in our backyard, and also enjoy food off the food trucks of today. So it's really a neat
event.
Well,
food trucks are one of those things that's really sort of cutting edge, and you know,
it's super trendy.
It's all the rage.
But we wanted to get in on
but
that.
But it couldn't be more fitting for you guys.
It certainly is. And this year we're doing a blueprint exhibit, which is neat. So we're going to have out all of our original blueprints of the food trucks.
Oh my God.
To go along with the event. So it's really neat. It's a really cool event. We're really excited.
Yeah, that does
about.
Sound really special. Any music? Anything like that? Is there usually music? Okay.
Yes, we do have a DJ. She usually plays like retro music, and she plays like old car ads, which are fun. We'll have that. We'll have a photo booth.
Oh, fun.
Which is really neat. We'll have activities for kids, face painting. There's henna tattoos, balloon sculptures, clown, things
now
like that.
Now, you mentioned Sly Fox. Is there a fee to enter, or just a fee to pay for your food and your beer? Or how does that work?
So, being a nonprofit, this is a fundraiser for us, and we do charge $5 to get into the museum and the fair. So regularly, like I said, it's $8. So it's kind of a deal.
It's
kind
cheaper.
Of a deal today on that day. So
it's a special event, but it's cheaper.
It's cool. Yeah. So kids 6 and under are free at this event. $5 gets you in both places. Mm-hmm. It lasts all day for the whole day of the event.
And then
you pay for food.
Pay
as
for
you go.
Food and the beer and things like
yes.
that.
Okay. Yes.
Very cool. Very cool. And this is the third year, you said.
Yes.
And is it just there in the parking lot, or do you do it somewhere?
We do it in the parking lot, which is adjacent to the entrance of the museum.
Yeah.
It's a huge newly paved parking lot. It's awesome. Everything takes place there. And then we have parking locations throughout town.
I was just going to say, I was like, so then where do people park?
Shuttle
or
all
what?
Throughout town.
Okay.
Which is all close. So the town's really close.
Yes. So
everything's right there.
Wonderful.
You won't have to walk far to get to our event.
Very cool. Very cool. Now, does the museum, do you have membership? Is it a membership organization?
We do.
And is that information, website, Facebook?
Yes.
You have both of those, I'm assuming?
Yeah, you can find everything on our Facebook page and on our website. We do have membership organization, like Amanda
you
said.
You're 501c3.
And like John said, we always need volunteers. We can always use volunteers. So you can find information about volunteering on our website or on our Facebook page.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Anything else that you would want to talk about that you can think of, mention?
It's a wonderful place for everyone of any age, children, not just car guys. You know, you can bring your wife or your girlfriend, and there's something for them to enjoy as well.
You mentioned about the renovation, moving those vehicles. Where did they go?
Okay, so we purchased a big warehouse that actually—
In Boyertown?
Yeah, right across the street from our museum.
Oh.
It used to be part of our campus, so to speak, of the Auto Body Works. We purchased that and we moved them all over there while the floor was being done.
Okay. So at least they didn't have to go far, I guess.
Not
right?
too far. Just across the street. And some of them do drive.
I was going to say, are some of them drivable?
Yes.
Or,
so some of them were driven across the street. Some were pushed by a few people, some by a lot. But so we got them across the street, poured the concrete, and then moved them back in and repositioned them.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
Wow.
A lot of work.
Definitely not a an easy task.
No, absolutely not.
I'm sure.
We're glad it's over and we're excited to show it to the public.
Yeah. So. Now, the museum is closed over the winter, right? Because I believe when Kendra was here before, did she... Is that why you planned the renovation for the winter? Or just because it's the slowest
time? It's a slower time. Yeah, yeah. We're not closed over the winter, okay. But it is our slow time, so it made sense for us to do it then.
To do it then, yeah. And then hopefully not cut into your open hours too much.
Exactly. Yeah, we were only closed for like 2 months, so it was actually pretty good.
That's not too bad. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's great. That's mm-hmm. great. I'm sure people were
Yeah, they're very excited to see the new museum.
Exactly.
It's a really important part of Boyertown.
Exactly.
So.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. All right. Well, anything else that you wanted to add, John, before we wrap up for the evening?
No, I don't think so. Except I think the trust buildings and the construction of them is absolutely fascinating.
Yeah.
There's a history to them that's just mind-boggling.
Yeah. Much like the historic
like
vehicles.
Yours.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yeah.
So much history in this area.
I know.
It's unbelievable.
I know. It is. Mm-hmm. It really is. Well, the food truck festival is fascinating to me because I think that's really cool since they were, manufactured there, and
yes,
it's kind of brings everything full
back
circle,
around.
I guess, yeah.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of food truck fairs around, but not
there
a lot
are.
That can offer this.
Yes,
that we're offering.
They can say,
yeah,
they can say that they were, manufactured and made here,
right in the building.
And you can visit the food trucks, then go and learn about their
history
and their construction.
Absolutely,
okay, where
it's
else
cool.
can you do that? Right,
absolutely,
where else can you do that? All right. Well, thank you both so much for joining us tonight.
Thank you.
And I'm sure we'll be talking with you again sometime soon. And thank you to all our viewers for tuning in this evening. We hope you have a great rest of your night. And thank you again.